Here's one way to make a crosscut saw sheath from channel lattice, a tough vinyl material that is available at most big box hardware stores. It is much tougher than fire hose, and the use of Velcro straps does away with strings that can get knotted and catch on things when walking through the woods. The first step is to hold your saw in a teeth-up position. This can be made easier by cutting a kerf in a 2x4 wide enough to hold the saw blade. Next, place the channel lattice over the radius of the saw and mark where you'll cut it to fit the blade. Channel lattice is sold in 8-foot sections, so one piece will be long enough for most saws. Veranda is the brand I use, and it comes in several colors. Once cut to length, use a bungee cord at each end of the saw to hold the channel lattice in place. Then cut a piece of 2-inch wide nylon webbing long enough to allow a full overlap and hold in place with a paper clip. Use a colored felt tip marker to highlight the overlap. Cut two pieces of 2-inch wide Velcro the length of your overlap. Rounding the corners of the Velcro will help keep it bonded to the webbing. Apply a light coat of shoe goo on the back side of the hook or loop Velcro and an equal amount to the webbing. Wait about 10 minutes and press the Velcro to the webbing. Flip the webbing over and do the same to the other side. Do not glue both hook and loop pieces to the same side of the webbing. If you make a glue-up board with small strips of hook material on one side and loop material on the other, it will hold the Velcro in place while you spread the shoe goo on. I've tried several different contact cements and shoe goo works best for me. Wait about an hour for the shoe goo to set up, then wrap your webbing around the saw. Use a soldering iron and carefully melt a small hole in the webbing on opposite sides of the channel lattice. Make the hole just wide enough for the screw shank, but deep enough to make contact with the channel lattice beneath it. Drill a pilot hole for your screws. I use a 3/32 bit and run it in the length of the screw. Channel lattice is 1/4 inch thick, so it is plenty wide enough for the hole. Finish mounting the strap by using round head screws to hold the webbing on. Your finished sheath should look like this. Now for the test. A saw sheath should protect you from the saw and the saw from any objects that might damage the teeth. How well does fire hose do that job? Poorly. The sharp teeth of a crosscut saw will easily cut through the rubber and fabric of a fire hose. When people bring me dull or damaged saws to file, I usually look at the fire hose that came with it. I can often align places on the inside of the fire hose that are cut through with chipped teeth or crushed rakers, evidence that the saw was not damaged in use but dropped somewhere along the way. Applying the same test on the channel lattice, the saw teeth could not be driven up through the vinyl, and the inside of the lattice was barely dimpled by the impact. Clearly, the channel lattice was much more protective than the fire hose.